www.pdcent.com.
Yo, what's happening? This is Judge of Souls. Yeah, right now I'm on a journey. I'm doing my documentaries. This is the first of the series. I'm going to interview a guy today called Quincy, Old School Foundation, Brixton 28. I'm saying we're going to do a deep interview, talk about some of his jail stories, life stories, shootouts. It's like a whole controversial journey. Some may not like it, some may be inspired. It's very deep, I'm saying. So we're going to go to his apartment right now, meet him, introduce him to you lot, and then go from there. Yo, fam.
Yo, fam.
Yeah,
what's the deal?
Yeah, well, man.
Every time you good, yeah?
Yeah, fam. It's good.
Hello, bro.
Rolex, that's minimal. Versace braces, matte cap, nuff clap. Big cash, big rings in my stash. Diamonds, cufflinks, diamond.
I take you on a sad trip into Cosimo Soul. When you never worship nothing except jewels, funds, and gold. Blood as they come, funds was my iman. I was lost in this dunya like an
amen. Yo, fam, what's happening? You right, yeah?
Just blood, just chilling.
Well,
finally invite you around.
Nice to be, bro. Nice to see you again, fam.
Yeah,
trust
it's
me.
Been a long time.
That's what I'm saying, brother. Love is love, love, it's love. It's love.
Yeah.
So, I was just telling the people that like, it's been a. So, like, you're a very controversial figure.
Mm.
Very controversial. A lot of people have been. There's a lot of, like, hearsay and rumors. And you're I always say you're like an urban legend. You've always been growing up. You've been like an urban legend. Like, a lot of people don't even know who you are. They don't know what you look like. They just heard the name.
Yeah, yeah.
The name
yeah.
spread around like wildfire. Like, everyone knows. In the whole UK, you say your name Quincy, they're like, yeah. I heard about that guy,
yeah,
serious
yeah.
guy. So just saying, today I just want to break it down and give a deep insight into your whole life, your journey,
yeah.
what you're about, where you're going, and just give the real insight. We're gonna turn the urban stories into a real life journey
yeah.
today. I'm saying so. We want to do. Tell us about you growing up when you first started. When you was like, if you can remember as a little. A young man, when the first time you remember, how was life for you? How, from your eyes, how do you see it?
Life, like the first things I remember basically was like, obviously, I was happy when I was young, when I was real young.
Yeah.
Yeah, the only family I had around me would have been like my mum, me, my little sister, and my cousin over there, Ayo.
Okay.
And his sisters and their mum.
Okay.
And Auntie Nancy. You see what I'm saying? So yeah, it's Auntie Linda, Auntie Nancy, and my mum. Because my mum and his mum are twins.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So obviously, we was close.
Yeah.
Everyone's come from Manchester,
yeah.
right? All my family.
Okay.
So obviously, we've been kind of, you know, like kind of displaced.
Really. Yeah.
And you know, we don't really know one them. No,
yeah.
No,
so,
that,
like, yeah. So you're like, you're just like me. I come here, not knowing no one. So
yeah,
that
yeah.
same, I understand that same journey. When you
yeah.
come somewhere, like, foreign land.
Yeah, really.
Yeah.
Everything we've got, we have to fight for, really.
Yes.
So I'm saying, in all different ways.
Yes.
Not physically,
yeah.
not mentally.
Yes.
All different type of ways you
yeah.
can think of. Because
okay.
we don't know anyone.
Exactly.
We just got each other.
Yes.
You know what I mean? And obviously, I was happy at that time. Like, inside. I might not have a lot, but
yeah.
I was happy.
Yeah.
But then obviously, my stepdad came onto the
yeah.
scene, innit?
Yeah.
When he came onto the scene, everything kind of changed.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Gates went up on my
yes.
house. It's the first thing I remember, you know, like windows,
yeah.
metal doors. You know, I mean, as a youth, like 3, 4, 5,
yeah.
I'm thinking, well, what's this?
Like, why is this happening?
Why is it happening? Yeah. Get me, it's out of the blue. And then from there, we kind of get separated from my cousin over
yeah.
there as well.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Because they're not allowed to our house no more.
Okay.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Would you say that he, your stepdad came with a militant, 2 militant approach?
Yeah, she was 2 militant.
2 militant.
From gates are going up,
yeah.
you know what's going on.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So, obviously, yeah, so. We was just in his world after
yeah.
that. I saw like my cousin in the aisle when I could.
Okay.
Not when I should.
Yeah.
When I could, because obviously they're not around at our house.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So.
So would you say that this built would you say that this where the anger kind of first
started
building up?
Because there was happiness before.
Yes.
Do you see what I'm saying? And in a kind of a way. me and AV's kind of reflection, we was kind of mirroring each other's life, really.
Okay.
Because the same thing I was going through, he was going through.
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying? So it was like, we're separated.
Would you say that militancy, would you say you took that on?
Of course.
On your whole lifestyle as well?
That came onto me, obviously. Because I used to like playing football, but he changed that and made me do boxing, something I didn't want to do.
Yeah.
But obviously, later on in life, that kind of helped me.
Yeah. So let's go back to the seats for boxing. A lot of kids at that age, when you're growing up and someone says you got to go boxing, as a young kid, you don't want to go play in the park.
Exactly.
So you don't really want to go boxing.
Yeah, we didn't do playing out.
You know, okay, so tell us a bit about that. Like, what was it?
There's no playing out, right then, there might be playing out sometimes, but you know, like, most kids have their regular, like, you know, you come back from school with your friends, I see you, I meet you in the park after dinner or something, or before dinner.
Yeah.
That don't happen in my house. My house is cleaning, you know what I'm saying, cleaning the house, making sure everything's nice. Do you see what I'm saying?
Wow.
Because obviously that's how he's programmed my mom.
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying? My mom was on this. My mom changed.
Yeah.
Or when he came into it, because his personality was just too strong.
Yeah. Because that happens a lot. There's a lot of parents like now that kind of happens to where their mom kind of takes the boyfriend side kind of and takes on his habits. You see, exactly. The mom took on more of his habits than her own habits. And
I told him from day one he can't touch me.
Yes.
Because he's not my dad.
Yes.
So he tried to kind of use my mom.
Yes.
To enforce.
Okay.
On me. Because obviously I was the one that was saying you can't touch me.
Yes.
The rest of them kind of, you know, they just went with the flow, but I wouldn't, innit? I might have thought he was doing good at the time, because obviously we always had things.
Yes.
Like, you know, material things like food or clothes or that.
Yeah.
But, you know, when you're growing up, those things ain't that important.
Yes, exactly.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So, and obviously, it's all about time, love and care and stuff, but that wasn't really there. It was just like, everything was geared to making sure he was safe, he was okay. You see what I'm saying?
So when you started going, after you started going boxing and the anger and a lot of the unhappiness has left, where did your journey take you to after that?
Well, what happened was, I used to go boxing, but he used to bring me to boxing, yeah? But then it got to a stage where he's got other things to do, innit?
Yeah.
So I became my own way to boxing. But as soon as that started, I ain't going
boxing.
You see what I'm saying? I'm going to my friend's house. You see what I'm saying? I'm linking people that, you know, that I've seen after school, you know, like when you get off the bus at the shop, going to Morley's outside, everyone's hanging around. I'm starting to meet my old friends there, really.
Yeah.
So as soon as I get away from boxing, he's bringing me to boxing, I'm going to link them and having fun on the street. Do you see what I'm saying? Not long, maybe a couple of hours.
Yeah.
But it's kind of like my first kind of, you know, like times that I've felt free.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
So after that happened, then obviously I started to link my friends a bit more, you know, start getting bunking off school, you know, you start to get drawn into the into the excitement, innit? So you get drawn up, you get bunk off school, then you get suspended, then you go home, make sure you tear up the letter before mummy sees the suspended letter. Chill out, the friends.
Exactly.
More and more in this game, so obviously everything started to pick up.
So how was school for you? How did you find your school experience?
You know, I was alright in school, but if someone said the smallest thing to me, I'll just explode.
You're okay.
That's how it used to be. I always used to get expelled or suspended for fighting.
Whoa.
You know what I mean? It was nothing else, it was just that all the time.
So,
and it was the silliest things really when I look back at it now. But it was just like, I just wanted to lash out because of the pressure at home, innit?
Oh yeah, exactly. Okay.
Because I couldn't lash out on them because they're the authority figures at home, innit? So when someone lashed out to me at school, I ain't got no respect for them. I just, you know, lash out at them basically.
What was your first encounter with, like, being arrested or something, or with the law, that kind of things?
The first time I got arrested, I showed you the picture. That first time I got arrested, I can't remember exactly what it was for, something petty.
Yeah.
But the first time I got arrested, they phoned my house. Yeah. And they took, and basically the response was, you can keep him.
Wow.
Do you know what I'm saying? But I really know that's him.
That's him
telling her to tell.
Yeah.
Because obviously he don't want police at the house.
Wow.
Because he don't know, but he don't remember. Man's living on the same place I've lived forever. Brixton Hill.
Wow.
Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. He lives there. No one doesn't know he lives there. Remember? He's shops on the front line.
Wow.
He's like one of the baddest guys around, keeping up mom's badness. And he's on Brixton Hill. Listen, you gotta understand this, it's not my mum. It's him.
Okay. Yeah, someone's speaking.
Do you know what I'm saying? Obviously, at the time, I was hurt more at my mum. Because obviously it's my mum and I don't care about him.
Yeah.
But you know, as you get older, you understand that you're sitting in jail so much time. You know what happens when you replay it all over your head. Do you see what I'm saying? He don't want police at the house.
Yes.
That is the end of the story.
The story, doesn't matter what's happening, you know, they're not coming in.
No, they're not coming in.
Yeah.
You can have him. He's not my kid anyway. Do you know what I'm saying?
Just straight.
So it's straight as that. I remember I used to go to these children's homes. Obviously, I had a feeling of loneliness in it.
Ooh.
It was very lonely because obviously, I'm going somewhere. I don't know what I'm going into. You know what I mean? So I was anxious. You know what I mean? Like, feeling sad, wishing I was back at home.
Yeah, of course.
Do you know what I'm saying? But I knew it weren't happening, so I just had to learn to be strong in it. Learn to be strong, deal with it, go in the children's home. When I was at the children's home, I never ever liked the environment.
Okay.
So I always used to just wait for my pocket money and run off.
Yeah.
Get a train back.
Wow.
And go back to Brixton. And I lick my friends and then stay at their house.
Wow.
Maybe as long as I could. Might not be long, maybe a few days, and then I just move around.
So,
and then like once my arrest in it, remember, I'm remanded into care now.
Yeah.
Because I'm building up court cases.
Wow.
I'm building up so much court cases, petty ones, but I'm not going to court, so they put me in care to get me to court.
And how old are you at this time?
Around 12.
Wow.
Coming up to 30. 12, yeah, 12. 12 coming up to 30, you know, in that zone there.
Wow. That is, I'm saying, so a lot of people are like, they know you're in, know you could be getting into trouble at 12 and being in so much trouble. Like, not just some people are in a little bit of trouble then, but you're talking about, like, you've got cases, you have charges, police are looking for you, plus you're in care, you're on the streets, and you're building a reputation as you're building this as well.
Yeah, obviously, I'm from Brixton, and I'm in Brixton, and the police from Brixton are looking for me.
Yes.
So it's not even like I'm in a different area. So I just know that I'm just constantly under pressure.
All the time.
Do you see what I'm saying? All of the time, like that, like you said, world on my shoulders. Do you see what I'm saying? Like, that's how I feel all the time. You get what I'm saying? I'm with my friends, but they're all right. I'm looking around for police.
Wow.
Do you see what I'm saying? I'm hungry, I ain't got no money. You get what I'm saying?
Wow.
So,
that's just, that's have so much. So much on your shoulders at such a young age. That is a lot. Like, I can relate to that. I obviously had a similar the similar lifestyle on my shoulder at the same time. But a lot of people, they don't have that. That's a lot of stuff. So you see, off that journey, okay, from the box experience to going onto the streets to get arrested, social services, a lot of you are very well known across the whole UK as Quincy the 28. How did your encounter with the 28s, how all your first encounter with 28s?
I used to go to this place called Dexter Playground.
Okay.
Which is on, you know what it is?
Road. Yeah, road.
Yeah, so obviously, when you go to there, right at the end, that's where all the older 28s used to be.
Yes,
sitting down in the little hut, smoking weed, cracking jokes, chatting, blah, blah, blah. Obviously, we're not supposed to be down that part, but that's how I used to get over, I used to climb over the fence there.
Okay.
And bam, they know me as, no. My stepdad's son, blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? Most of them had little encounters with him, you know, where they look easy to for them because they saw that.
Like,
but you know what I mean? But obviously, we cracked jokes with them, and then obviously they started, you know, passing weed around and stuff, you know what I mean? But from then, they kind of took a shine to me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that was my first encounter with them, you know, like Duffers, Sykes, Squids. That was like my oldest at the time.
Wow.
You know what I mean? I didn't know this before, actually, but obviously, that's how the relationship started from there.
So Duffus was a very big, like, he's one of, like, a main figure. He's another notorious name from, like, everywhere in the UK. You mentioned Duffus, so, like, that's that, like, Brixton guy, that, rest in peace, that, like, he died. I'm saying, so what was your experience with Duffus? Because that was like, some people, they just heard rumors about him, like, you actually been around him.
Duffus. If you know him properly, he's a good-hearted person.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? Like, he'll give you his last five.
Ooh.
Do you know what I'm saying? That's how I know Duffus. Like, if he sees me, he'll ask me about it.
Yeah.
Because he knows I'm on the ropes.
Yeah,
he'll just ask me about it, stuff like that.
Whoa.
But obviously, one time, we got kind of like in a bit of a madness.
Okay.
Because basically, I was having an argument with a girl.
Okay.
And her dad tried to start on me.
Okay.
So, as he tried to start on me, Duffus came out of nowhere and just knocked him out. Like, on the outside, you know, where Morley's and that used to be, stuck at, but right there. So it was after school I was in it. So after that, he got arrested for it. Yeah. And then remember, I'm on the run.
Yes, already.
I'm constantly on the run.
Yeah.
I'm on the run for knife point robberies, burglaries. Cause these times I'm hanging around in Angel Town,
yeah,
chilling in Delhi B, stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? So obviously these are the kind of times we've been buying a bit of ting now as well. You know what I'm saying? So I don't care what anyone is going to say to him. But he's telling me I've got to come to court to be his witness. I'm saying I can't go to court, I'm on the run. You know what I'm saying? So he said, no, you better meet me here and we go to court. And I just said, yeah. Never met him. Yeah? And then one day, I'm walking down the road and I heard someone go, oi! I'm looking around. I'm thinking, wow, where did that oi come from? I know that oi as well. I know that voice. Yeah? So I'm walking backwards. So I walked off and then someone said, look around. I see Duffus moving like you saying, ho. Yo, down Brixton Road. Like you saying, yeah? Before I know it, this guy just had me right here. Yeah, long strides. Yeah? He said, where you at? It's me. I can't go on court. And then he went, bang! It's me. It's me, Duffus. Now, what do you mean? You've got to come court, but I helped you, bro. But it's me, listen, I didn't ask you to knock out the guy. I didn't ask you to knock out the guy, and I'm on run. If I go on court, I've got too much charges to answer to.
Yeah.
He said, you're coming to court with me. So he brought me, He brought me to some girls' house,
Wow.
Some hostel.
Yeah.
Hostel from St. Matthew's. So now I'm sitting down in this hostel room at the table, Tired, it's all 3 a.m. He's lying down on the bed of the girl, just watching me, having little jokes to the girl and I'm thinking, can I go to the toilet please? He's in, it's right there.
Yeah.
Bro, I jumped out the window, second floor, I was gone. I was gone.
Wow.
You get me? Next time I heard, obviously, he got arrested in that, but he had lots of other things for me in that, but I only got arrested in that.
So you see, like, say for the younger 28, so like you lot, who else was around that you lot, that, what was your circle at that time, or younger 28s?
Short man, Cleo.
Yeah, Cleo.
He was like my best buddy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like me and that guy really started some stuff, you get what I'm saying, Cleo, then you got Beaver.
Yeah.
Mr. Slick. You know what I'm saying, And then, who else you got? Jabai.
Yeah, Jabai,
My good brother, Jabai.
RV.
RV
was Delibi. Delibi,
You get me? That was really the main. That was you get some handlers on.
Hang around RV.
You get some handlers on me. Those were the main people that I used to be around. And then Ninja as well.
Yeah,
Ninja was where he was about, innit?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So the main
he was
circle.
A bit funny, him.
Yeah.
He was a bit funny.
So what did you. So see, at the time, there was a lot of like. Disputes still going on. Like now we have like obviously there's loads of gangs, wannabe gangs, and like, well, at that time it was like Brixton, what was the other areas that there were conflicts with at that time?
At the time it was only really us, Brixton, Ghetto Boys and Junction Boys. Ghetto Boys we had not more problems, but we had more skirmishes with them. But that was because we also been into their territory. Every week we got a moonshot.
All the time.
No one could have come Brixton all the time.
Yes.
Yeah, that was unheard of.
Exactly,
There was no Ghetto Boys coming to Brixton. There was no Junction guys coming to Brixton. But we would go to their dances every week. And that's why we have more skirmishes.
Okay, there is a main story. This is through every jail cell, every street corner on the fight with Quincy and Sparks. This is a very, everyone, every, I went to jail and every jail I went to, there's someone talking about this incident. Give us a brief of this incident before.
In jail though, but we never had a fight in jail.
No, that's right, they talk about fights.
Oh, they're talking about the fights in jail.
Yes.
Okay,
that's
what I'm
saying. So that's how serious this one story has gone from. How did that journey start with you and Sparks?
Well, what happened was, obviously RIP to Sparks and obviously one day I was going out with like the main girl at the time, her name was Carlene, isn't it?
Okay.
Yeah. So obviously they had a little bad feeling about that as well, innit? Yeah. But obviously me, Jabai, and I think even Flowers was there. And I think Beaver might have been there as well. They went to follow me up there, innit? Yeah. So follow me up there. Then when we get up to like New Cross where the train station is, we see around 30 Ghetto Boys, innit? Yeah. And then obviously they seen us first, so they just came straight for us, yeah. But then there was like, I think there was an older there.
Yeah.
So the older was saying, yo, one-on-ones, innit? Yeah, then obviously, them not going like, they don't want to fight, innit?
Yeah.
None of them. You know what I'm saying, yeah? Because obviously they're saying whoever's fighting is fighting Sparks, innit?
Yeah.
So they didn't want to fight, so I could feel someone pushing me in my back.
Yeah.
I don't know who it was. But they pushed me.
You know what I'm saying? So before I was there, like, ah, and cool, it's back. You know what I'm saying? So we went down some side road.
Yeah.
And they went in the side road now, and everyone formed a circle, innit? Yeah. So obviously now, we just, you know, like two pit bulls.
Yeah.
And then obviously, he's throwing a few punches, but then, obviously, I know I'm skilled in what I was doing, because obviously that was close to my boxing period. I gave him a few combinations, and these boys just jumped on and said,
No.
Yeah, because obviously he was at the stage where he was like, like dizzy, innit? And they just stopped the thing, no. And then I was waiting, and then they said, his arms dislocated.
It's okay.
Can't fight no more.
Wow.
So when man said that, them lot said, yo, let's get out of it. You get me? So man just started moving quick to the high road, jumped on the bus, and we was out.
Wow.
You get me, bro? Obviously after that, there was a few little more things like where, because obviously now they're kind of mad, innit?
Yeah.
Now they're blads.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So if we go peck them now, they hear about it, they're flying down to Peckham. Yeah. And there's a pub on Peckham High Street.
What's it called?
Like when you're getting up to Peckham, it's on the right.
Right outside, yeah, I know it's one.
Yeah, it's right. Is it called the Castle or something?
Castle, yeah. What the Warner Castle or something? Yeah, something like locked down now,
I don't know.
It was locked down now, yeah.
But yeah, that was there. And we was in a party there.
Yeah.
It was around probably 8 of us, short man, all of us was there. And then some little youth came up to us and said, yo, you man, better get out of it. I said, what? Get out of here, little youth. Oh, what are you talking about? Man's bad. You get it over. You get what I'm saying? He said, nah, bruv, get out. You get what I'm saying? Because obviously, even though there's a little young pecking you, they don't like ghetto youths.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like they know we're the only ones putting pressure on them.
Yeah.
So that's probably why he came and told us. Because we're pecking that, you ain't got
nothing
to tell us. But obviously, he wants to see, like, things happen to them.
Yeah.
So he's watching our back. So as we come out now, I think Jabai went round, looked down, yeah, and see Jabai. When he gets boomy,
you know,
he starts, his spit starts coming out, he's like, yo fam, man, yeah, man, yo fam, trust me, come on fam, start grabbing his knee, bro, what's going on? He said, look down the road, I saw one bag of utes, and you know what, bruv, I saw baseball bats,
wow.
I saw machetes, I saw everything, bruv. You get me, yeah? So bam, man took it. Saw short man said, yo, let's blow. It started blowing.
Yeah.
But you know how it is? It's like when a dog sees you running, innit?
Yeah.
The whole of them. Look, the whole thing was going.
Whoa.
Like, bro. Short man, he's the fastest runner. He's like way out in front. He's going, yo, you man, keep up, man, keep up. I'm like, yo, fam, I can't run that fast, bro. You get me? And he's dusting, so we're dusting the gardens.
Yeah.
So we're dusting in the gardens, and then bam. He's starting scaling fences, but he is scaling them in one jump. You get me, like, boop, over, yeah? Me and Jabai done two,
yeah?
As we got to the third one, yeah? It's like, our body was just saying no. Just saying no. So there was a little bush in the corner. So me and Jabai are hiding in this bush now, yeah?
Hiding.
Listen, man was under the, like, you see the bushes there?
Yeah.
Man was under it. Underneath, you know, trying to blend like that.
I'm trying to go under the bush.
So like, if they look round the bush, they can't even see anyone. Man's under the bush, bruv. You get what I'm saying, yeah? Jabai said, be quiet. Don't say one thing. What am I going to say, bruv? He's like, it's just shh. And then bam, we heard the tools coming in the garden.
Whoa.
We heard that, you know, like on the pins. Like, have you seen that? What's that film? Have you seen it? Warriors.
Warriors, all the gangs. Yeah, ching.
That's what man's here. You got what I'm saying? Perfect. Man's saying, yo, where are they? Bare different voices, bro. Man, scared. I am scared. My heart's beating like this, yeah? Because obviously we're trapped.
Yeah,
and then bam. They was in the first garden, and we're thinking, nah, they're not going to come in this one. And then bam, we had the gate open. They came in, yeah. All that was in there, yeah? Then one guy said, there they are.
Whoa.
Here's me, whoa! Yeah? And it wasn't even me. God must have took over, yeah? I just jumped up and said, yeah, what do you want? And then they started backing off like that. So when they started backing off, I started backing off and Jabai started going, yeah, what? What do you want?
Yeah.
And he started going into overdrive, yeah, what? You think you're mad? And then we eased out of the garden, yeah? And then there was this guy, what's his name? Some guy, Coxon's cousin or something. What was his name, man, from Acre Lane? He used to wear Avex jackets. Dark skin, twist.
Shiloh.
Will tell you. Shiloh saw us come out the garden. He said, yo, you that cunt. Because you know what it is? When you're younger, big boys seem very intimidating.
Yeah.
Remember, we're still small youths, innit? He said, yo, you man can't touch them, man. And he said, yeah, you man go. And Me and Jabba just got off, bruv. You get me?
Wow.
Survived that, bruv. That was like straight instinct, bruv.
What age group was that?
That was like 13, bruv.
Wow.
13.
You are very well known for like setting the whole bank robbery, the whole scene.
That was really short, man.
Yeah, you lot are very, like, so tell us how, like, your first incident, like, that led into you to go to prison for the bank robbery. What was your first one?
Obviously, yeah, everything's building up, innit? Like, obviously, you know, it's, you know, first man started licking phones, like, cars, busting arcade machines, you know. Man's got so much charges against their name, but they can't put me in prison.
Okay.
Because I'm, like, 14, innit? I'm too young, yeah. And then, so maybe around 6 months, just before I hit 15, yeah, we must have just walked. We must have been walking. Walking past a train station, yeah. We just walked in there, and I just went on the door. I said on the door, and then the woman opened the door. I said, "Wow!" I just dived in there. The drawer was full, bare money. All of us were just ransacked the drawers.
Wow!
You get me? Got a few grand.
Wow!
You get me? That was the first taste of proper money that we had. Wow. And after that, it was just anything we thought that had grand in it, we just moved it up.
Wow,
that was it.
So that caused like a scene at the time that was like unheard of. People saw that in like the action films. So
remember, there was no guns.
That's what I'm saying. So that was like wow, are these guys really running places and just grabbing money? Like,
just grabbing money.
You don't really like, obviously I was young hearing, but like I was just a bit younger hearing that, like, wow, like these guys are running, jumping and grabbing money. So I'm obviously just the ones underneath you, because we're just one year younger. We was like, yo, we have to do this well. So obviously we copied suit, obviously we followed suit. But see, so what was the first one? Because you went prison at, what age did you go to prison at? 15. Wow, so what did you go to prison for?
Bank robberies.
Wow, can you tell us, what was the first like bank robbery done that you got arrested for? What was the actual adrenaline rush? How did you go do it?
The bank robbery that, obviously, after that, just done a few little, you know, like, it was just like, it wasn't kind of like robbing the bank, but we got to, it was just kind of like, you know, going to pass the bank, seeing someone drawing out bare cash, running there, snatching.
Yeah.
That was the first thing. But then what happened was, I must have sat in a bank at lunchtime, just reading one of the, you know, the pamphlets.
Yeah.
And I waited for them to open the door. As soon as they opened the door, bam, I flew in. Them lot saw me doing that, and they flew into the bank.
Wow.
And all of us were behind the couch, just grabbing money. And then after that, we started looking for ones with, because man thought that was a bit too much hard work, innit? So man started to look ones with, you know, building sites, no counter, no screen. So what we're doing there, just running there, straight jump over,
straight,
and just ransack the drawers. You get me?
You lot made the police actually, they created a thing called steaming.
Yeah, they changed that. Because first we got arrested, we was getting for theft.
Yes.
But they wasn't happy, innit?
Okay.
Because obviously people was getting like birds.
Yeah.
So what they done is they changed it to steaming. But stroke robbery.
Robbery.
Started saying that we don't need to touch anyone to be robbery. We just have to make them be fearful that we're gonna do something.
They actually changed the law.
They changed the law.
Wow.
Because the way we was approaching.
So that's like 15-year-olds putting pressure on the Metropolitan Police to change the law.
That is
serious.
Yeah, obviously at the time you don't realise.
Exactly.
Looking back
now, that is very serious. Wow. So you got arrested for that one, and your first, what was your first spell of prison like?
When I first went to prison, it's kind of different over the years, because when I first went to prison, do you know at that place where they, because now they just bring you straight to prison.
Yeah, they
just, but before there was a place where they used to bring everyone. Okay. There's a holding centre. All the vans from all courts, they used to bring all the prisoners to this one place.
Wow, I didn't know that.
They used to bring them to this one place. Wow. And then from there, they ship you out to your prisons.
Okay.
Yeah, so that was the first place I went. You get me? Wow. Like, obviously, I'm seeing all these guys from all different sides of areas. But you know, like older guys.
Yeah.
Like, obviously, when you get into the prison system, you work out who they are. You're like name brand guys from the areas and that. You get me? And I met them in there.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So I got kind of like introduction to certain people in there. And I mean, then when I went in prison, obviously, I've already been through that feeling where I'm going into the unknown, you know, from going to children's homes. So I don't feel as apprehensive as I should really for going first in prison, because I've already built this feeling up. I've kind of conquered that feeling a bit, if you know what I mean.
So being back kind of by yourself, like, I could do this,
but going into that unknown, I've really kind of conquered that feeling. So I'm in prison, and obviously, you just feel it out for a little while, and when you feel it out, then obviously you get used to it, and then whatever's whatever, you just start fighting everyone, man.
Wow.
And that's what happened, I was fighting anyone from anywhere, anytime.
Wow, that is
what I'm saying.
So you went, so we went in when you was 15.
Yeah.
What was your first sentence?
5.
5 years at 15? Yeah. Wow.
Came out when I was 18.
Wow, so, you know, so after, so you went through the prison system, all the jails, learning about yourself, and when you come out...
But don't forget, I escaped on that sentence.
You escaped to that sentence?
On that sentence, I escaped in it, they remember the court.
That's when, remember that, that was the days when it was, you get all the stripes you, when you get put back in the after you get.
Yeah, they bring us to court. It was coming up to Christmas,
yeah.
And everyone was talking about, what is it? What is that? What was it, Astoria again? What was that? What?
Wow.
Orange.
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 Wow.
I heard about Orange so many times, yeah, that I just needed to be there, bro.
What, you heard about it from prison?
I heard about Orange in prison.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? And everyone's saying, yeah, Orange this, Orange that, Orange that. And I'm just at my window hearing about all these Orange stories. I'm thinking, wow. Bam, I went to court. Everyone was in there. Me, Short Man, Fat Shane, a couple other people. Man sitting down. I think even Fat Shane was the one who suggested it. He said, yo, bro, should we dust up? It's me. I don't mind, you know. You know, it's just one of the things I don't mind. I'm not asking, bruv. If my one that's out, I'll dust up. And the man saying, oh, when the screw comes,
yeah,
everyone just push out.
Yeah.
So again, what do they do? Everyone talks about it.
Yeah.
When the screw comes, everyone's sitting like this. You know what I'm saying? So who sets it again? Me and Short Man. You get me? Just went straight out, went out. When we came out onto the, you know where the bus is? You know, yeah. Buco.
Wow. Yeah. Right in the main road bit.
Yeah. Yeah. So when you come out into the van, yeah, the guy's on the van waiting for you to come up.
Come up, yeah.
So Short Man went that way, yeah. And the man looked like, where did you get?
Yeah.
So as he went, looked round, I shut the door and went down.
Okay.
But their gate was not on no lock, it was just drawn.
Drawn.
So we just drawn it and ran out. By that time, I could hear everyone in the cells like fighting with the officers.
Oh, what?
Trying to get out. Because they realised that these guys are actually doing this. You know what I mean? They're trying to get out now. So me and Short Man are dusting out. As we look back, we see around 3 officers on top of Fat Shane. Like, down to the ground and stuff, forget me. Next man get hold, me and Short, we just kept on running straight to the train station. Got a train, came out, Clapham Common.
Whoa.
Ran to my mum's house, forget me. Got some change of clothes and I was gone. Straight to Delibee's. All over again, started licking it every
straight
day.
Straight over again.
Yeah. Short Man gave himself up though. People made him, people talked him to give himself up in it. So, tried to do an emotion.
Did you end up going to the Orange?
I went Orange. Yeah. Orange.
Yeah. Orange. Wow, that's a, that, what, that, when you came out now, there was, so right now, is this like there was a, during that age group, there was a, like a, like, especially when we was young, there was like a crack epidemic on the streets, yeah, like, yeah, where a lot of young youths were smoking the crack, we call it, at that time, was calling it ting. It was more like a, like, it was like a big man ting, like, he was going on things them times when he was running the ting and making money. So tell us that journey, that, how you experienced with the whole cocaine and drug era.
Like the first time I probably bun ting was with Bridget Harvey.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying? He kind of, you know, on the flats at the time, because he was a bit older. And
yeah.
he was a bit more, at that time he was a bit more advanced because he was a bit more tapped into the older guys that were around the state because of his brother.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So he could get more things done around there than most of us, innit? Yeah. So obviously, he would have access to it, and you know, me and him would bun it, me, Deli B, Yosh, Yosh and that. They would just be around and that, and that was how I first started.
Yeah.
And obviously, you know, going on the roads, then I find out that Short Man's bunning as well.
Yeah.
We start bunning together.
Yeah.
You know, just little things like little bones and rub a little thing, do a little half pants.
Wow.
You buy half pants at that time, you're excited.
Yeah.
Like, that's a big
serious thing. Yeah, that's serious thing.
You get me? Like, so I used to be able to steal cars.
Yeah.
Because obviously I was in the children's home. And, remember White Justin?
Oh, yes. Okay.
He used to be in the children's home. Me and my Toots.
Yeah, Toots. Yeah. And
he's a bad boy driver. Yeah. Justin's a bad boy driver. Justin teaches me how to steal cars.
Okay.
You get me? So I can steal cars, but I can't drive them.
Yeah.
Shortman can drive. So Short, me and Shortman link. I'm starting link black boxing mini metros. You know what I mean?
Old school, yes. Barbie told me that.
Shortman driving him. I'm in there. We're bunning ting. Listen to Snoop Doggy Dog. You get me? K-Boy used to link cars. But that Snoop Dogg, you know that that's the tune we used to sing all the time, just sitting in the car on Tulsa, just bunning till morning. And then obviously he'd probably drop me off somewhere, because I couldn't say exactly, his mum was a bit strict. Get me, we go to Harvey's or Delibee's. You get me? And then obviously now we want more in it.
Yeah.
You don't know it, you don't know it. But it knows it inside. You want more than what your money is. You get me? So obviously first we're buying like alpha pants, and then we're going to the yardies and saying, give me everything they got. Do you know what I'm saying? So you buy like 20 stones of him and 5 alpha pants at one time. Do you know what I'm saying? We're not even thinking, if you buy a half ounce, maybe you could last longer.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We're just in a rush. We're just on a bun. So we're bunning all that, and then start trusting something, because obviously they see us coming with money, start trusting, they ain't getting paid, you know what I mean, yeah? They start looking for us, and we don't care, we're on the run from
everyone.
We're on the run from life.
Wow.
Do you know what I'm saying? So that ain't gonna make no difference. For us. You know what I'm saying? So, but then after that, we started doing these robberies.
Yeah.
So when we started doing these robberies now, man's buying their own quarter. Short will buy a quarter, I buy a quarter, Delaby buy a quarter. Do you know what I'm saying? And we just sit down at Delaby's house and just smoke until the morning. But obviously, because all I really needed at the time was me and Shortman.
Yeah.
We weren't really asking about these other
people.
Yeah, me from Shortman's, I got Shortman's back, Shortman's got my back.
That's it.
We do anything.
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying? So I wasn't mine that time, and obviously we're bunning together, bunning bare money together. We just go hit it. As long as we buy 2 outfits, the rest of the money can get blowed on thing. We don't care. I'm talking about, we could have 5 bags.
Whoa.
Do you know what I'm saying? We buy two outfits, maybe a little chops on the wrist. That rest of the money, that's a straight clone. But it was more of a like status kind of thing, innit?
Exactly.
It wasn't like man was fiending or something.
Yeah, no,
it
was
fiending like, you know, like, oh yeah, man's tramped out.
Yeah, of course.
Obviously man had the best clothes on.
Yes, of course.
Man had nice jewelry, man had cars, man had everything, but it's just that man just wanted more of it.
Yeah.
More of it. And the more money we get, the more of it we buy.
Whoa.
You get what I'm saying? And obviously we got even girls. It's girls that man is probably, next man probably idolizes on the street. There with us bunning ting to early hours in the morning, bro. You see what I'm saying? So kind of the whole of the area was bunning.
Yeah.
It was bunning. It was just normal. It was
normal.
So if you
were
bunning,
Man's looking at that. Yeah, it's like it was outside, like, what are we doing? Not bunning. Yeah, that was.
Talking about the bunning weed. Weed. Because obviously the ting goes with the champagne, innit? Both of them
together,
they taste nice.
It's like a Scarface kind of thing, they know what we're doing this thing, we're living the life.
Exactly.
We're living the life thing.
That's what it was. And because we was hanging around with older boys, remember I told you I was hanging around with like K-boys, all the brothers and that? One time we went to this place called Wax.
Wow.
Yeah, Wax Club, East London.
Yeah.
That was Tin City. I've never seen a place like that. Like even the bouncers are bunning Tin.
Everyone.
Do you know what I'm saying, bro? Like usually you can go to some clubs and the bouncers see you bunning Tin, or you get out. No, he's asking you for like 2 draws.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying? That's how the bouncers are moving in there. So after that party, they brought us to a house. And when we went to that house, this is the first time and the only time this has happened to me. Yeah, I walked into the house. As I walked in the house, there was a girl with trays.
Wow.
Trays, bruv. And so I'm like, well, she's like, yeah, take one. Go into the sitting room, there's some next guys in there. Everyone's got their own tray. The room is silent. Everyone is just focused, but in bare tick. There's tick on every tray, cigarette, Rizla. Everyone's just sitting down. There's no talking. Everyone's just.
Wow! The silence.
Just silence, bruv.
Wow.
Silence. That's what we call a ting party.
That was a ting party. How old was you at that stage then?
Yeah, that was before my first birth. That was 15.
Wow!
15. That was 15, yeah.
That is serious.
I was 15. Like,
so just say, so we're living a Scarface life.
I was on the run.
And on the run?
Escape.
That's what you escape.
Escaped. Yeah.
Wow.
That was that period.
So we see when, so now you come out, you've done all that, you went to jail, you came out.
Came out.
What was the next journey when you come out of prison?
Well, obviously when I came out that next time, I already knew that I'm coming out to hit again.
Yeah.
I'm hitting it bigger this time. That's the plan. I was thinking that was a joke.
That was a joke.
Yeah, I want more money.
Straight.
Yeah, so after that now, man just started going at it hard. Look, 6 month period, yeah. Bunning thing again, but it was a thing of I got nicked, me, Fat Shane, and you know Nuts Keith.
Yeah, Keith, yeah.
Yeah, Ninja Kid.
Yeah.
And K-Boy.
Wow.
We all got nicked to get me. Yeah, bam. Slapped me with 5. They slapped, I think them and they got freezing.
Like,
yeah, freezing twos, and they slapped me with 5, innit? Yeah. So obviously they got out after a while,
yeah,
having their fun and that. Yeah. And I'm just in jail still, innit? Yeah. But this time, because that time now is like, that was for a reason.
Yeah.
Because that made me decide in that time there that I am not bunning to
ever again. Yeah,
I don't know why.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I did, and I said, I'm never going to commit them robberies again.
Yeah.
because I was thinking, nah, it's played out now.
Yeah,
it's played out now, innit? So that I stopped. So when I came out, I didn't know what I was gonna do. But I didn't think, oh, I'll stop crying forever. Yeah. But I just knew I was gonna commit for a reason, I went by the tick. I just knew that I made my mind because I even stopped smoking in prison. Yeah. So I got out, chilling, and obviously my sister, she's going out with Eric.
Yeah.
Yeah, Tipsy.
Tipsy, yeah.
But obviously before I went to jail, me and Tipsy was doing moves.
Okay.
Do you see what I'm saying, yeah? That's what people don't really even know. Do you see what I'm saying? Like 1997, me, him, and Exit.
Yes.
Yeah, we're doing our own moves. We're looking POs. Whoa. Do you see what I'm saying? Because they're vehicles.
Yeah.
Innit? So I was linking them, he's doing that. And obviously I came out. When I came out, he's in my sister, innit? But obviously now, he's got one ends locked. Yeah. Camden, innit? Everyone knows, innit? Like,
but just let me say, see with that, with you coming out of prison and being from Brixton, and you, at those times, you went and linked someone from Peckham.
Yeah.
People was mad it on was the streets. Crazy. I remember people saying, what is Quincy doing? He's on the streets linking Tipsy.
Crazy.
Obviously, I knew Tipsy from school, so it was a thing to me because I grew up with them lot, so I grew up with Peckham people and all that. So I think because I've got like a, I'm from Berlin originally, I got a different mentality already. Yeah, so I'm like, I don't give a fuck about all that.
People's just people.
That's what I'm saying.
Exactly. People just people.
So we had a different mentality.
There you go. Just is what it is.
So that already, you caused a big, by you just doing that, it was a big thing. Like, people's like, whoa, what is my man doing?
But obviously, I don't hear that.
Yeah.
But I feel it.
Yes.
You know, in my dealings with people.
Yes.
Or when I see people. And
yes.
Even certain people around you are who, even like certain people I'm partying with.
Yes, you can still see.
They're chatting about me.
Yes.
But they're linking me to party.
Yes.
That don't make no sense, bro. So I've got bare snakes around me. Get what I'm saying, bro? Because obviously, they're looking for a little handout.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And because obviously at the time, we was kind of like the talk of the road.
Yes, of course.
You know what I'm saying? Like, everywhere we go, all the parties, everything's happening around us. So they don't want to miss out.
Yes, of course.
They don't feel, man.
Yeah, yeah, same time.
You get what I'm saying? They don't really feel, man, but they're around, man. So obviously, but obviously, I had my own kind of cloud around my head. Remember, I'm making them.
Yes.
I'm getting all the girls. Everything's all right for me. So I don't actually, I kind of miss out on certain things that I should have picked up on.
Yes.
And maybe things could have been a bit different if I picked up on these things. But obviously, everything was nice. So, and no one was touching us.
Yeah,
so I wasn't asked, you get me? But obviously, like, you know, people wasn't happy. And through that, a lot of other things happened.
Yeah.
You get me? Like, a couple of houses got robbed around us. And you know, it has to be people around us.
Yes, of course.
Because no one else don't hold the locations. And then, before you know it, there was a problem with Eric.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Now, this problem's not with me because people from my bits, are telling me, you're not from
Peckham.
Mm. We know it's nothing to do with you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They ain't got a problem with me.
Course.
So they're trying to separate me from my boy.
Yeah.
But me, I'm low.
Yeah.
I'm not separated from nobody. Yeah. Do you know what I'm saying? That's who I eat with, that's who I sleep with. Do you know what I'm saying? So, sleep with no homo. You know what I mean? That's who you get what I'm saying? That's how it is.
Of course.
Do you get what I'm saying? So, so I'm not leaving my man whatsoever.
Yeah, of course.
Do you know what I'm saying? So, things escalated, people started shooting at us. Do you know what I'm saying? But obviously, there was a situation where the first time I got shot at, Eric got a parcel.
Yeah.
DHL.
Yeah.
Yeah. And in that parcel was a bottle of oil.
Yeah.
Yeah. And there was a letter, and the letter said, make sure you use this oil because from next week, everyone around you is going to start shooting at each other.
Wow.
And I'm like, what? Do you see what I'm saying?
Whoa.
I'm like, whoa. I'm like, what?
Whoa.
Yeah, everyone's going to start shooting each other. And I'm thinking, now, I ain't been shot at you.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I don't know what these people are talking about. I'm thinking, this is nuts. But being me and me, because I'm very spiritual. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, put religion aside, I'm spiritual being me. I'm just spiritual. Do you know what I'm saying? So forget every religion. I've been through every religion, I'm spiritual, you get me? I deal with God. I'm spiritual in my heart, So I pick up vibes. When I pick up vibes, sometimes I go with them.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? So I looked at the oil. And it said, stand on two pieces of brick or stone and take your shoes off and your socks, then drink.
Wow.
That's what it said on the thing, so I done it. You see what I'm saying? Now, Eric didn't do it.
Yeah.
He just drunk it, just with his trainers on. He was in the car, he just drunk it. And bam, bam, we get in the car and we go to this party. So we get to this way to this party. Now we're driving down Fort Neath. And now we're driving down Fort Neath Main Road. And then we take a right. As soon as we take the right, my body just went like this. I'm like, oh, bro, what's going on? He stopped the car, he's like, what's wrong with him? He's like, I don't know, bro. My legs are shaking. I try to hold it. It won't stop. He's like, bro, what is it? Is it, let's go back home. He's like, nah, bro, I don't want to go back home. But just pull over for a little while. So I'm shaking. My body is jerking.
Wow.
Obviously, you hear things about
it, of course. Yeah.
But this is happening to me, bro. My body is shaking. I cannot control it. In my tongue, yeah? And when I'm trying to talk to you, my tongue, yeah, I'm thinking, wow. You get me? So we got into the car park now. Our friend Bugsy was behind us in his car, yeah? So as those two have got out of the car, they got out of the car to like piss in the head. But remember, they're moving normally, casually, innit? So they got out of the car, they had a piss, they're laughing. I'm sitting on the seat still, yeah? Because when I put my foot out of the car, yeah? My foot started to hurt when I put my foot out of the car. So I put it back in, yeah? But then obviously I know I have to go to them. So I put my foot out and I'm thinking, every time I put the sole of my foot down, it's like I'm stepping in fire.
Whoa.
So what I started to do now, I started to walk on my tiptoes and I'm holding my hand, yeah? But I'm way behind and they just walked on because they're just thinking, we're getting into Soul Solid. So they're thinking, wow, so we're getting.
Rave,
yeah, they're thinking we're getting into Soul Solid, they're raving. So I'm behind them on my tiptoes, yeah, like that. Because I'm on my tiptoes, yeah, there's a car over there, yeah? I could actually see in the car because I'm on my tiptoes.
Yeah.
If I wasn't shaking and on my tiptoes, I would have passed the car.
Yeah,
and as I passed the car, they would just obviously attack us then. Because I'm on my tiptoes, I was looking and I could see like heads in the back of the car like leaning down. My instinct just said, yo, tipsy, run. As soon as I said that, yeah, I just heard bitter shots, man.
Wow.
Bitter, bah, 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 bah. And as soon as that happened, that feeling just went woof to my body.
Wow.
Woof. And then I ran, a bush again. I went to clear the fence, bam, fell into the bush.
Whoa.
Yeah, and I saw the guys walking around the bush, like, where did he go? Because they couldn't understand, because obviously they see us all fly over the fence.
Okay.
But they wasn't sure if I flew over the fence.
Okay.
But I'm in the bush again. And they go, where has he gone? Then I had bare police, and then they just got off.
Whoa.
You get me? That was the first time anything like that happened to me.
Wow.
A few things happened to me after that.
What was he feeling like, in the bush? What was he feeling in the bush? Like, wow.
I remember I was just saying, please God, don't let him get me. Please God, don't let him get me. That's all I said. I remember saying that.
That is serious.
You get me? I remember saying that. Please God, don't let him get me.
Yeah, so after the bushes and all, after all that, what was the next situation that with you and Tipsy's kind of friendship? How did what after that incident, where was you back? Where your head must be crazy, like, wow. That people are trying to kill you, you got haters, you're making money, everyone's talking about you, like, what was happening?
So this time, obviously, at the beginning, we never had no firearms, innit? We never had no use for no firearms, because obviously, we're just making money, life's sweet.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? We don't even need anyone, because obviously, we got cats. We only got cats.
Yeah, it's nice. Yeah,
nice. Cats are, you get me? We don't even need to talk to no one, we don't need to bend no one. Then obviously, certain people around us started to get sacked off the line. Because obviously they weren't performing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that made the kind of certain Peckerman started to, that same feeling that the Brixton guys had about the Peckerman guys started having off him.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? Well, I'm not sacking him, it's my fault. He's sacking him. You let him perform, it's not my fault. Do you know what I'm saying? So obviously, it's kind of like, it just kind of ended up being me, him, and Bugsy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because it's like us free.
That's a free circle.
Yeah. Because I started to see fun in this type of people. Because by the time now he's got shot, now the cloud's gone.
Yeah, of course. And
obviously tipsy.
Eyes wide open.
Wide open. That's any funny move.
Yeah.
Stop linking in, phone change.
Straight.
You know what I'm saying? It was just like that. So it just came close.
Yeah.
Kind of close ranks. You get me? Some next guy around has got shot. But obviously he was from out of town, but man still had his back in it, but he didn't have our back, so we just lodged in.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He was kind of scared.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it was just us three rolling around. But the thing is, we're still getting parties.
Yeah.
We're not even thinking, oh yeah, we could get killed. We are still partying every week, getting Coliseum, Derby, coming outside of raves, getting shot at. You know what I'm saying? Having shootouts outside raves. It's just normal procedure. We're thinking it's fun. It's not funny, we need to back it now, because we couldn't lose our life all the time. But that's what we're doing, still going out, raving, blah, blah, blah. So now, obviously, we're buying a bare fire. Any fire on that moose, yeah? If you got a clip, I want that.
Straight.
You could have just a one shot.
Wow.
I want that. Because man is extra paranoid. Man's just filling up. And then obviously we're buying little whips, stuffing up the whips with the things. And so anywhere we go, anywhere we know we go, we need them things close.
Yeah.
That's if I got a girl over there in the car, packed, house packed. That's how man is moving. Because obviously man's paranoid, but man still has to work on the line. And obviously we're working on the line, and we go to Camden. Feds know what we're doing, but they just can't catch us. Yeah. We've got workers, innit? So that's how it was. And also, when we go rave, we're strapping up.
We're both.
And obviously, James, no James?
Yeah.
He started hanging around him, I was in it, Because James, James like the excitement, innit? I know James from jail, innit? Like, he was just like, when I first met him in jail, he wanted to fight me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He wanted to fight me, But when I brought him in the cell, he's like, oh, thank God, there's better people out here. I said, you know what? I like you, man. I like you a lot, bro. You know what I'm saying? So from there, meaning clicked together, So, he started tagging around with us. Boom. So, obviously, we got a little team, man. Obviously, I got faith in them, Like, obviously, man will do their thing, innit? And Gems, you know, he's gonna do his thing, innit? So that's live, innit? And obviously, Remy's been in man from day one, innit? Remy just don't leave, man. Obviously, he probably had a few haters around in his ear talking about that same,
same
concept
thing,
about being a but he stayed in man, you get me?
Yeah.
So, I love Remy. So, so it's just us now. Me, Renz, Bugsy, Gems. That's the team now, innit? Yeah, so we're still rolling, going out parties, When we seen anybody now, it's just anyone, even talk to these guys. When I see them,
it's straight.
You get what I'm saying? That's how man's moving. Like,
wow.
Man's just in the mode where they don't care.
Yeah, of course.
Man's been shot at too many times. And the way I'm seeing it is we're the victims.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't shoot no one.
Yeah, of course.
Tips didn't shoot no one. We got shot at around twice before we bought any firearms.
So you took it yourself as well.
You know what I'm saying? I think I've got the license to do what I want. That's how man's looking at it. Wow. Ain't you gonna feel the same?
Yeah, of course.
You ain't shot no one, you ain't done anything, as far as you're concerned. And people are shooting at you, so obviously, anyone that's connected, it's just fun. That's how we were rolling. You know what I'm saying? So, and then obviously that day, and then obviously, tips got nicked. Like food and all different kind of conspiracy charges. So he got taken off the road, and it was just left with me, Bugs, and Rents, and Gems. So obviously one day now, obviously man's still got the line in it, So I decided that obviously I'm gonna buy a QUINCY and a submachine gun, like a proper powerful thing, So I bought that now. When I bought that now, I just felt invincible. I didn't care if I saw 30 of them, 10 of them, 20 of them. I was just in the zone. You know what I'm saying? So Bugsy used to call me and said, let's go. Yeah, and I just been getting this rolling around town in his bike, looking for anyone. Didn't find anyone. It's like, no, my man got this thing, my man can't see nobody for some reason. You know what I'm saying? So, man's rolling around one day, go to my cousin's house. And when I go to my cousin's house, I saw one kid outside the house. And the motorbike's running as well, outside my cousin's house. So we just drew up to him quickly, As I drew up to him quickly, got off the bike. I said, yo, bro, what are you doing outside my cousin's house? He said, no, nothing. As soon as that happened, and he's back, he's up behind me. Yeah, so obviously, I've got the thing of it. They can see that there's aggression with motorbikes around there. They want to stop us, they're blue light. So I just jump back on the bike in front of them, put my helmet down, and told Bugsy, drive. So we're driving now. Driving. His house ain't far. He was in high school. So as we pulled up to his house now, got off the bike, jumped into his car. We jumped into his car now, I looked in the rear view mirror. I said, yo, Bugs, you need to turn your bike light off. The bike light's on again. As soon as he stepped out the car, I was like,
whoa.
I looked into my mirror on the side. I saw three baddies, like creeping to the side of my car, to my window, innit, I just climbed out the window, I got the thing. I didn't even look, I just went out the window. You get me? And when I look back in the rearview mirror, I saw them all dusting out. So, you know, it's when the enemies run, you run after them, innit? Jumped out the car, yeah? And I wasn't even aiming. Like, you know, I was aiming like I was in the movies. It's just like, shooting cars, everything just mad. But then obviously there was like some, an old woman and an old man and a little kid in that way to run along. They was like doing a little one pops from down there, so I just went in the air. Like the cross, you get what I'm saying? And even the judge said, yeah, if I didn't do that, we would be in the show. You get what I'm saying? Because the woman and the man said, yeah, you actually need help us. You get what I'm saying?
Does that help you?
Yeah, yeah, it helped me along because obviously I've got 20, so if I didn't do that, I'd take that into consideration and that. You get me? So that's man's heart, I think. Man's just,
yeah, he has a natural, yeah.
If I'm doing bad things, man's still.
That's like the spiritual level always kicks in, comes kind of say, you know what,
that's sort of what's scared. Yeah. And obviously, then nothing can do with it.
Yeah, of course. So you see, after that, like, there was one, the main incident, like, this was a main story when you were with.
Same
day.
So, tell us about this. Obviously, we got in our cars, drove off. So, we went about our business. Yeah, but obviously, now, man, pumped today. Man, pumped. Man, phone Gems, man, phone Rams, man, phone T. Man said, yo, get the cars. You get me, we're rolling. So, man, getting the cars now, we're rolling. Now, obviously, we're going everywhere. And man said, yo, man, let's go there. Man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, let's go Atlantis. So, man's got two cars, man's got a ringer. Yeah, and man's got another car, you get me? So, yeah, drive up there now. Well, I'm in this Audi. So, I'm in the Audi, like, me and Gems. Rest in peace, yeah. We in the Audi driving up there, and then bam, police car pulled up behind us. So obviously they knew it was us. You get what I'm saying? They're on us straight away. So I'm thinking, wow, yeah. So I pulled the mag to see how much. I went to pull it to see how much things was left in the thing, yeah. And then shot just went off in the car into the dash.
Whoa.
And the car just went boom. You know, like because you're the Audi,
everything's
boom.
Stop.
I said, oh my god. Them lot have already drove off,
yeah.
Or Remy and them, they drove off, yeah. But I don't know, something must have told them that there was something wrong because they see the car was dark.
Okay.
They just see it and then they just reversed.
Exactly.
Yeah, because even the police said, oh, we must have phoned them.
Yeah.
We didn't phone them. We never had no phone
calls. Like, yeah, yeah, yeah.
They just reversed back and we jumped into their car. So now there's five of us in this car, you get me? So we're in this car now. Everyone in this car, everyone's strapped in it, yeah? So we're driving now, driving. And now, I told my man who's driving, take a right.
Yeah.
He was so scared, he didn't take a right. He took a left, and went all the way back around and came back outside the ring again. Can you believe that?
Wow.
Outside the ring. There was like 100 police out there already, yeah? And they saw this same police car who's been following, tried to follow the Audi, following me in episode. They were joined into the chase. So we're sitting in the car now. There was so much lights, yeah. Bro, my clothes were blue, dog. It's like,
wow.
It's like inside the car was blue. You know what I'm saying? I've never seen so much lights before, yeah. So we're driving now. And we're not even driving fast, isn't it? Because there's so many of them behind us. When we're driving down the road, you can see them all there.
Yeah.
You know, like, waiting for us to pass to join in.
Wow.
Like with the president.
Yeah.
And we're getting convoy, like, you know, like Man's Obama.
Yeah.
And they're just waiting to join. And we haven't driving fast because we know.
Yeah.
In a way, we knew we was screwed, didn't it, yeah? So I said to my man, I'm saying, yo, what are we gonna do, bro? Because I said, I ain't getting back to the job, bro. Do you know what I'm saying? The man said, no, I'm not getting no answers. So I said, you know what, bro? Man's gonna have to bust at them, you know, bro. Man saying, no way. I said, alright then, cool, say nothing. But we kept on driving for a little while. Then when I realised we was getting more to fall beneath, yeah, it's a bit more, yeah. I just put the thing out the window and just went.
Whoa.
You get me? I didn't know where I was aiming, I just pulled out the window. As soon as that done, I threw it out the window. I told Remy, give me your thing. He said, no. I just grabbed it off him, started busting that, took Jim's thing, started busting that.
Wow.
And everything was empty.
So he emptied the whole, everyone's
things. Everyone's things, yeah.
Whoa.
Everyone's things.
Like, serious.
You understand? And then boom, we got out the car now. The car kind of, we got into Fort Worth and crashed into one of them, you know, the reserves.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then obviously everyone was ready to jump out. But then the car came back out, driving, and then I think they put a stinger in the road. You know, the tires got sucked. Yeah, the tires got, and then the car just slowed down a bit. As the car slowed down, I jumped out the car. I remember when I jumped out the car, saw them police guys, you know, the ones with the black and white squares on their hands. He had like the head clear and car, she said, don't move. But that did not register. I ran straight past him, started jumping in gardens, cleared the gardens, bro. I ran, yeah, until I ended up in Crystal Palace.
Wow, from 14th to Crystal Palace.
Crystal Palace. I just cleared and scaled gardens until I got to Crystal Palace.
14th Crystal Palace is a mission. So
I ran that, and there was even a helicopter.
Outrun the helicopter.
You know what? Have you seen Metal Gear?
Yeah.
Versus Metal Gear. Yeah, I just played that game in Pen. There's a level.
Yeah.
When the light's up, yeah. You got to actually follow behind the light to get top, because obviously you can't run through the light. So you have to follow the light. But one time, I had to wait for the thing, and actually follow the light.
Wow.
So I followed it all the way around there. And when he went around that way, I just kept on going straight.
Wow.
That's how bad it was.
Serious.
I was living like Matrix.
So after that, did you all get away?
Everyone got away apart from Bugsy. But I thought I was the only one got away. I was thinking there's no way anyone's getting away from that.
Wow.
So later on, when I got my phone back, I'm seeing my phone ring. Thinking, oh, who's that? Germans. Germans phone me. Man, you get me? Remy phone me.
Wow.
T phone me. I'm saying, how? Everyone got away except for Bugsy. You get me? So obviously, after man got away, obviously, man was a bit hyped. Obviously, man was paranoid.
Of course.
Yeah, because man's thinking, I'm hearing already that everyone's calling my name.
Straight.
Everyone's calling my name, so I'm thinking, it's only a matter of time.
Yeah.
Before feds come for me. Yeah, yeah. So I've got all the phones turned off. I'm moving incognito. And then, after a while, I must have went to link someone. Yeah, but there was a number that I needed that was in one of the work phones. Turn the phone on. Yeah, as I turned the phone on, took the number out, turned the phone back off.
Police have arrested two men in connection with a shooting outside a Croydon nightclub. The two men were arrested in West London yesterday after armed officers fired plastic bullets at their car, forcing it to stop. The arrests come 4 days after a 27-year-old man was shot at the Atlantis nightclub in Croydon. Officers who gave chase were also fired at by a gunman in a car.
There was a rubber bullet shooting the car.
Wow.
Police, you get me? So I just turned that phone on for like 2 minutes and they found me.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? Just like that, bro.
That's serious. So they must have been waiting.
It was waiting.
Just waiting to, hoping that the phone they turned on.
Waiting, yeah. That is the work phones.
That is deep. They're thinking, these guys are hungry for money. They're going to turn the phone on.
And I wasn't even turning on
for
money. Yeah, turning on for a number.
That's what I'm saying.
You get
wow.
me?
Wow. So that's how serious they want
to McDonald's. Full of McDonald's. You get me? We was there. Yeah, I turned on the phone, turned it off, met the guy. As I left the guy, we took a right. And as we took the right, I saw some tinted window cars, a Saab and a Golf. Following, I'm thinking, that's enemies. You got what I'm saying? Because they're tinted.
Yeah.
When it was boy them, you get me? And then as soon as we turned the right, I just like, bah, 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 bah. And the car just went, it just kind of wobbled. And before I knew it, I was on the floor, just, playing petite, just getting kicked up and stuff like that, you get me?
Wow, and that was all over the news, everything, that whole incident was everyone on the news. Tell us about when you got arrested, like you're in prison and then ready to get sentenced.
Obviously, his man's trying to bust case in. Yeah, everyone's trying to get out. You know what I mean? But obviously, for me to get out, my story would kind of implicate other people.
Yeah.
So I just said, forget that, I'll just run this case where they stitch me up.
Yeah.
Because I've got guys who are meant to write in the case, but it's like they don't want me to run my story to get off because they hardly got evidence on me.
Yeah.
So I'm saying, if you're banged to rats, you might as well just say, I touched that gun at your house.
Yeah.
Because you're banged to rats. You got caught at the scene.
Yeah.
You got caught. You got bulletproof
vests.
You got guns. The car's in your name.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? They've got you on camera with the next car as well.
Okay.
And you're shooting outside your sister's house earlier in the day. They know it's you. So I'm saying, you might as well just say, that gun, I touched it at your house, and you can let me go home.
Yeah.
But man's in their mind, they're thinking they're going to run some case that they got kidnapped.
Yeah.
But I'm not one to hate. Yeah. So I said, you know what, bruv? Cool, I'll just run I got stitched up case and try and bust it down.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I done that. It was looking good. We had bare points, bare Archibald points. The judge said, listen, Archibald does not matter in this case. This is too serious. You got what I'm saying? Because we had an angle where they should have thrown the thing out at half time because all the evidence in the car was contaminated.
Yeah.
Because they didn't see that the car, they just left the car in the garage. in an open garage. Wow. You know, where you could walk in, anyone could walk in. They left it like that for a month until they arrested me. And then they went back to the garage. Do you know what I'm saying? So, really, they should have thrown that. All that evidence in the car should have been thrown out, but they didn't. Because that evidence in the car ties me to the case. So without that car, there's no me. So he said, forget that. This, the thing in that car is sticking. You know what I'm saying? So I went through all that, about like 4 week trial or something, going there every day. And then one day they just called us on Saturday. On Saturday, I couldn't believe it. You know, Saturday, you're thinking you got your weekend, just to chill. They said, yo, you're going to court today. I said, bro. So the big day now, I stand up in court. And then there was bare police there, innit? Bare police I never seen in suits. Get me some different police, you know, that's waiting to see me go down, innit? So I'm sitting there now, they just said, I was the first one to die, because there's hardly no evidence of me. But they said, yo, wait, you stand up. I said, what? They said, no, we've already been found guilty. And then he said, yo, wait, stand up. Stand up. He said, yeah, you're getting sentenced today. I'm thinking about the rest of them. You know what I'm saying? They said, no. They said, you're getting sentenced today. They said, you don't need no reports. They said, why don't you need no reports? He said, have you seen his criminal record? And this guy don't need no reports. I know how to deal with him today. He said, in fact, I'm going to give him a mandatory life sentence. So the judge said, for what? They said, oh, because he's a repeat violent offender. So I called my barrister quickly and I said, listen, I've never been nicknamed. From all them robberies, there's no violence. I said, you need to check them. Bring out all the transcripts.
All of
the robberies. So he went and got them, came back next week, and he looked through all of them, and he said, yeah, actually, you're right. He didn't touch anyone. Not one person got touched.
No violence like that,
Bam, he said, all right, then cool. You're not going to get life, but I'm going to give you more than the rest of them. And he said, stand up in 14 years. You get me? You know what? At that time, I'm not really thinking about that. Yeah, it was only when I heard Eric got killed. Because he had some dailies in it, and then he got killed. So, in a way, it's like, I felt it and I didn't feel it, because you know what I done? I blanked it out of my head by I started taking beer drugs, smoking beer weed, drinking beer hooch, and we take it, every weekend, it was me and some group of Manchester guys, we used to have e-parties. You get me? As soon as we have our lunch in the morning, ease, ecstasy, until the next morning. Just partying every weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And obviously, that's what we look forward to every week. You know what I'm saying? That's what we used to do all the time. So, in kind of way, I kind of blanked it out. You know what I'm saying? That's how I kind of dealt with it at the time. You know what I'm saying? And then, boom. Obviously, Justin died, Jens died. I'm thinking, wow. I'm thinking, it starts to hit me, but I'm still in that drug mode. You know what I'm saying? And then boom, my enemies came to my prison. Prison I'm in, they should have been. So I know police sent them in there, because I'm convicted and they're remand. Wherever they done was wherever it was, it's not even in the same location. So I don't know how they get into my prison. So obviously it's a straight setup in it, So we had a little fight in prison, and then boom, before them, they moved me out of prison. So obviously now I've gone to Franklin now, which is Durham. So it's still ACAT prison. But it's far, innit? It's just like white people. There's even a landing called Mississippi. That's how bad that is called Mississippi, bro. No, there's no black man on that spur. Even if you come near the spur and you ask the officer, have you seen Joe? Oh yeah, he's probably on Mississippi. Even the screws call it Mississippi. That's how bad that is. See what I'm saying? So I'm in there, but I don't know too much people now. It's just mostly white people. So I ain't really got the access to all the weed and the drink and the visa. So it's I'm coming down now.
You're chilling out now.
I'm coming down now. But then obviously, Tips is gone. Tips is a man I used to write to. You know, let out. Feelings. Express things. You get what I'm saying? That's gone now, isn't it? So what I had done, I started looking at his letters and that. And he used to write little rhymes at the end. You get what I'm saying? And then, so when I'm going over his letters now, and this is when it's starting to hit me now. Because my mind's clear, innit? You understand? But when it's hitting me, it's like something's coming over me, but it's telling me to write. You get what I'm saying? So I just keep writing. I keep practicing and practicing. And there's one yard guy that I know, called Edwards. You get what I'm saying? He's a good friend still, some Jamaican guy. He was in there, and I said, because he was the only one I know, I said, go to him and say, yo, how does this sound? How does this sound? And he said, said, yeah, man, that's good. And he used to have a little, him and his little yard friends, they used to have a little session in the afternoon.
Yeah.
So obviously I'm starting to get invited now, because obviously I'm making choruses.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? I'm making choruses, they're pressing record, they're doing the verses, and obviously that's how I started to become good at like choruses and rapping. I got my confidence, you get me? From then, I used to stay up till like 6 in the morning, just writing, non-stop, non-stop. And obviously, through my life, I've not really been one to talk, but that was like the way of me. It's like getting everything out, just write it down. You know what I mean? I just started to write my own book, you get me? So I started to write poems, little scripts, you get me? And then obviously, kind of because I missed my childhood, I've got a wild imagination. Do you know what I'm saying? I've got a wild imagination, bro. Like, I can get ideas out of anything. You can show me that, and I'll just make 50 different ideas out of it. Do you know what I'm saying? So, that's how the kind of creative side came into it. You know what I'm saying? And then after, because I was so far away from home, I put application in to move back. So they moved me to Whitemore. You get me? So when I moved to Whitemore now, some guy came in, some guy called Glenn. Yeah, he came in and he done like a conference about, you know, the effects, you know, gun and knife crime has in your area, and how you can make a difference in that, innit? Obviously, there's all of us, there's like, you know, all the top guys, and they actually pinpointed them and brought them to that thing again. So everyone's sitting down there, stubborn, and like, you know, like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I started to listen,
you
know what I'm saying? I started to listen to him, but obviously, he can't tell me what I know. He can just tell me what he can find out.
I know,
But I'm thinking to myself, rah, he's making a lot of sense to an extent, because obviously there's lots of people getting hurt that don't need to get hurt. Do you see what I'm saying, yeah, so I'm thinking, I started talking to him, innit? When I started talking to him, he told me, oh yeah, boom. Like, people like you can make a difference in your area, and like, they get me. So I'm thinking,
yeah.
But obviously, I went back to myself, and I was thinking about what you're saying. And then I started writing stuff about it. Do you see what I'm saying? And then the more I started writing, I started more believing that I could, because I'm thinking if I can have a negative effect on my area, because I left my area in a mess.
Yeah, of course.
Do you see what I'm saying? In a mess, if I can have that negative, I can have a positive
result.
Do you see what I'm saying? That's the way I started to see things. I said I had so much power that way, because I know when I left here, little youths were trying to be me.
Or ripple effect.
You see what I'm saying? So I'm thinking, if I could turn it around, but I know how it is, they're not going to listen to no preaching. They don't want to hear no preaching. But I thought, oh, I found this gift now, right? So I'm going to bring it like that. You see what I'm saying? And tie the two together, I can start doing positive things. I'm making music. You see what I'm saying? I can start to have a life now. I've never had a life before.
That's
you know what I'm saying?
What's your mindset like right now?
Right now, my mind state is I'm going with this music. You get me? Like, obviously, I came out, Friends, forget them. They're all fake. Do you know what I'm saying? You know, like, there's so many of them. Like, 95% are fake. Forget them. You get what I'm saying? You probably can find maybe three, four maximum good people, friends who make relate to you in your life. That's about it. The rest of them, they've all got their own uses for you. You know what I'm saying? This man's partying with you because he knows people are scared of you. You know what I'm saying? But he wants to hang around with you. No, he don't want to do nothing for you. He just wants to be seen with you. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm with certain guys, they're falling guys. Say, yeah, I'm with you. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? He knows what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? But they pose as friends. You get me? I had quite a few of those guys. You know what I'm saying? Guys I was hanging around with in prison. You're saying, come out of the road, it's a different thing.
Of course.
And you hear they get shot. And when they get shot now, they want to phone you, you're friend again.
So what you find, because what is one thing as well, why even people that watch this now, they'll be thinking, Jaja, Quincy sit in the same place. Like that alone is a lot of things. A lot of people think, because when before you went in, that whole drama and that whole thing that was happening, that caused a big split. And what you find, a lot of people was taking sides. I'm one of those people, my loyalty is always different. I'm like that, I've always been that from a young, I think it's because I'm not from London, I think I'm from Birmingham, so I always think differently.
I'm grounded,
like I'm saying, so I always say, no, this is how I am. But I know two set people, that's how it is. I'm not trying to jump in the middle of two sides, I don't do that. But there's a lot of people that with two sides.
Yeah, definitely.
What would you say to people? Because there's a lot of people, even there's some people now that they don't want a true side. They want to be like, they do want to say, you know what, I'm just grounded, but not that much. Just I would say as a sensible people.
Yeah.
Some you get the little wannabe people that will try to pick sides.
Yeah, see them people there, they should just, you know, like, first think about themselves, then think about their family, because that's the most important thing. Because them people that they think that they might be holding any torch for a load here, they'll be the first people to forget them when they're in trouble. You see what I'm saying? Like, they could end up in jail like tomorrow. You might hear a few phone calls. I've been through it. You hear a few phone calls for a few months. After that, you don't see what. It's only 6 years, 5 years. See them faces that you're seeing there, that's your people. You know what I'm saying? Other people there, you don't hear from them, you know what I'm saying? So
real.
I wouldn't really really take that kind of thing too serious. First think about yourself, first think about your family. And at the end of the day, if you think like that, everyone could come together and make bigger things happen. You know what I'm saying? There don't need to be no divide.
Yeah man, that's good man. So right now, it seems like you're on a very progressive path. So what kind of people and things have got around you right now?
Well, obviously, you can see like I've got my album coming out soon, so right now I'm dealing with music. You get me, like I've got Young Gun helping me out, doing a little joint venture. You get me, obviously I've linked Judge.
Yeah, of course.
And obviously I'm just linking people like I'm in an empire right now. Instead of just having people who around have got their own agendas.
Of course.
You know what I mean? If I see someone doing positive,
of course,
and I want to get on the positive path, I'm gonna do them. You get me?
That's what you
That's how I'm going for.
Yeah, of course. Yeah fam, so imagine we come from the streets, Brixton, and now we're standing in a place like this. Like, how does that make you feel?
I feel beautiful right now, bro. I'm seeing a bigger picture, bro.
That's what I'm saying.
Enough men don't get to see that bigger picture, bro. Enough men's passed away. Man's here actually living this, seeing a bigger picture, bro.
So we've got a lot of progressive things. You're part of a lot of progressive things. There's someone today that you've that's with you. Like to like tell us a bit more and introduce him.
Yeah, man. Obviously, this is Malachi, innit, yeah?
Tyrone.
He's like my brother and that, innit, yeah? Obviously, now, he's got an organisation that I'm supporting him, and we're going to push this thing together. It's called Positive Paths. So, like I said before, if you're on positive things, I'm on positive things. We come together and we make this thing happen, man.
That's cool.
It's the same way I link Jaja. You get me? You see what I'm on, I know what he's on, we're moving forward, so. This is
Malachi. What's happening, sir? You right here? So tell us a bit about what you're doing. Like,
started Positive Paths on was on Remand in HMB. And I came out and I thought,
to make a change.
We'll do something in this community to make things different. Yeah? Now, I mean, Positive Paths, got to be on a positive path to do things as key to see. Obviously, we've all started off in a struggle. Like you said, no struggle is no problem. I want that there to be my name.
Exactly.
Yeah?
That's what I'm trying to say.
We want to be there.
There you go.
Exactly. So obviously, that's what Warrior's all about. I mean, we've got Calm. Yeah? We've got the Calm project, we've got the U-Turn project. We've got so many projects that are actually bringing in the young people, and actually doing something changing. We've got Anti-Knife and Gun Crime projects. I mean, and that's one of the biggest things that the government is seeing as one of the bad things. But who better to teach these young people and who to do it apart from the people standing here today that have been through it? Yeah?
Exactly.
Now, reading from a textbook ain't doing nothing. Because like he said earlier on in the interview, I won't listen to him.
Exactly.
Like obviously, but the people that have been through it, we can make a change and we can do something.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the way that we're
That's good,
forward.
Man. So what's your website?
Yeah, it's www.positive-path.co.uk. Get me, follow me, Malachi Positive, till her.
What kind of future projects are you looking to do now? What's the movement? What are you looking to do now?
As I said, it's a mentoring service at the moment. The movement, I want it to be a youth centre.
Yeah.
I want to have a youth club. I want that closure.
Yes.
Yeah. I want if a youth feels that he can't go home.
Yeah.
Like obviously Quincy was saying earlier, he couldn't go home to certain situations. Things weren't right.
Yeah.
I'm not understanding.
That's a big
We're them understanding people.
Exactly.
That are bringing the community back together.
That's a big move.
We all started as one.
Yeah. That's a big move. That's what I'm saying. That's good, man. That's what I'm saying. So obviously we're doing stuff, and obviously the people are gonna make some powerful moves. Obviously, so people are gonna look out for you. So that's a big move, man. Much respect for that.
Yeah.
Much respect. You know what I'm saying. Yeah. So bam, then let Quincy do his thing now. He's gonna give him his little shout outs towards the end. Big ups, bam.
Lender, this is a rap, innit? But obviously now, mixtape's coming out straight out of the pen. Coming out. Gonna drop an album next year. Check the Weatherman album as well. Yeah, boom. You're gonna be seeing big things from my cousin AV next year as well. Boom, next some Jaja. Don't know if you've heard from Malachi already. But I just wanna big up my mum, Shan, AJ, Shiloh, Karina, Vienna, all my cousins, IO, AV, etc. Young Don, all his family, mum, sisters, cousin, Jess, all my aunts, uncles, Deegs, two pools, father, son, all my Scouser family, Blacker, Starboy, Nathan, Glenn, Sue, Dan, Paro, Ann, Mikey, Ilias and Penn, Pingu, Mario, Jimmy the Gent, Shems, Smiley, Mez and his family, Shade One, Aline, Wass, Young Screams, Skywalker, Tapdi, Skanker, Dewey and his family, my Uncle Amin's, Uncle Alan's family, Florence, Jermaine Abbott's mom and his sister, Joanna, RIP to Sparks, Tipsy, Gems, Justin Morgan, all haters in jail, all haters on road, it's all good and it's all understood. I feel you, yeah? And short man, my Danka, you don't know, we really started this shit, yeah? And yeah, big up my boy Adam Deacon, you know you're certified for life, baby. And my homegirl Ashley, forever that positive voice. And most of all, the creator, that positive force. Been more than hard work, but we did it. Now it's our time, HR Medici, Hitmakers, ER we are, Qozo Medici, clouds by day, fire by night, we're untouchable. It's a wrap.
Yeah.